Hewitt from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. In less than a week, L.A. County could lift its outdoor mask mandate for public events. COVID hospitalizations fell below the target of 2,500. A four-acre brush fire destroyed two homes and damaged another in Whittier. The fire broke out behind a cul-de-sac in the Sycamore Park area and burned for about an hour and a half. Billionaire developer Rick Caruso is expected to announce he wants to be L.A.'s next mayor. Caruso filed an intent-to-run form with the city clerk. Four deaf high school football players from Riverside will be honorary captains during the coin toss at Sunday's Super Bowl. Last year, the boys were part of a historic season in which the California School for the Deaf went undefeated before losing in the state championship. Southland weather from KFI, sunny and hot again for your Friday. Mid to upper 80s are forecast for inland areas, upper 70s to the beaches. Right now it's 54 in Garden Grove, Irvine 63, El Monte 67, and in North Hollywood at 63 degrees. We leave local from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. I'm Phil Hewlett. In Fountain Valley, there is a full freeway closure. 405 northbound from Euclid to Brookhurst. All lanes are going to be shut down for road work until 5. In Linwood, this is on the 105 eastbound. Right before the 710, we have a conked-out car taking up the right lane there. Tow truck's on the scene. Watch for delays as you approach this area. Diamond Bar, there is a work zone 60 eastbound from the 57 to Diamond Bar Boulevard. Two right lanes are going to be shut down for road work until 5. KFI in the sky helps get you there faster. I'm Brian Vance. I think it's a super idea to get bowled over by going to Morongo to watch the big game. And now the top five reasons to visit Morongo. Number five.
Game day stay. Get a room and two tickets to the big game blitz for one low price. Call 888-MORONGO.
Number four.
Big game blitz. Watch the big game on big screens in the ballroom. The big game is this weekend, and Morongo has big games for you to play, big prizes for you to win, and of course, big screens for you to watch.
Morongo Casino Resort and Spa. Morongo. Good times!
Omicron spreads faster than any other COVID-19 variant, so it's important for you to mask up to limit the spread. N95, KN95, and KF94 masks offer the best fit and filtration. Don't have these? Surgical masks. Or double masking with a surgical and fabric mask can also offer great protection. So there you go. Mask, vax, and get boosted. Learn more at COVID-19.ca.gov. Brought to you by the California Department of Public Health.
Each week on the Talk Easy podcast, you'll hear intimate, long-form conversations with today's most interesting artists, activists, and politicians. It's the podcast where people sound like people.
I want to go back. You're laughing at me.
No, I'm just noticing you have a very seductive voice. So it's like, yeah, yeah, let's go back. Yeah, I want to go back. Wherever you're taking me, I want to go there.
Listen to Talk Easy with Sam Fragoso on the iHeartRadio app or wherever you get your podcasts. Brought to you by DuckDuckGo. Protect your privacy online for free with DuckDuckGo.
Hey, it's Dean Sharp. When my clients need solar, I call Sunlux. The best design, service, and equipment, and hands down the best warranty in the industry. Other companies sound confident, but Sunlux gives you real guarantees. If your solar ever fails to produce what it was designed to, Sunlux will pay the difference in your electric bill. That is the Sunlux difference, and it's why I say there are only two kinds of solar companies in Southern California, Sunlux and everyone else. Start saving money today at sunlux.com. That's sunlux.com. CSLB 1008374.
Just one run-in with the law can put a huge burden on you and your family. Just one arrest can change your life forever. I'm Darren Cavanoghi from 1-800-NO-CUFS. One criminal conviction can cost you huge in money, your driver's license, and even mean real jail or prison time. If you've got just one chance to make just one phone call, make it 1-800-NO-CUFS, the leader in criminal defense. We're here to help. 1-800-NO-CUFS, because no one looks good in handcuffs, unless you're into that sort of thing. 1-800-NO-CUFS.
Want to boost your immunity and protect your community? Get a COVID-19 booster. They help keep you and others safe from the virus and its variants this winter and beyond. If it's been at least 5 months since your last dose of Pfizer or Moderna, or at least 2 months since your last dose of J&J, it's time for a booster. Visit myturn.ca.gov to find a booster near you. Let's keep our immunity strong. Get your booster and flu shot while you're at it, too. Brought to you by the California Department of Public Health.
KFI, AM 640. Presents Coast to Coast AM with George Norrie.
We're going to take your calls next hour with Bill Bean. If you want to jump aboard with demons and all those other fine things, that's what we'll do next hour on Coast to Coast. 685 people shy now at ParanormalDate.com. That's it. To reach 124,000 signed up members. 685 of you sign up at ParanormalDate.com. And if you're over 60, ParanormalDate.com/seniors. Is just for you.
At ParanormalDate.com, you meet the most fantastic people.
Hi, I'm Tom.
Hi, I'm Jennifer. What brings you here?
Yeah, I'm here to meet someone who understands me.
How so?
Well, I'm into UFOs, ghosts, aliens, Bigfoot, conspiracy theories, the paranormal, that kind of stuff. But can't seem to find anyone who gets it.
Oh, well, nice to meet you, Tom. I gotta go.
Okay, guess that's not your cup of tea? You sure?
Very. Good luck with that.
I can't meet anyone when I'm out, and I really can't find a website for my unique interests. What are you going to do?
Have you thought about ParanormalDate.com?
Paro what dot what? Who are you?
I'm a paranormal matchmaker, and it's ParanormalDate.com. It's a website for people looking for people like them. Stuff you like, remember?
Interesting. I'll give it a try.
Well, let's try this again.
Hi, I'm Tom.
Hey, I'm Deb. Your profile on ParanormalDate.com looks very interesting. So you really saw a UFO?
Well, yeah. It was so intense, but not as intense as me and you.
You're an alien chasing a twerp, but I kind of like it.
Wow, this ParanormalDate.com thing really works.
Maybe ParanormalDate.com is for you. People with an interest in things they hear on George's show find their match daily. So if you're looking for that special someone with an interest in UFOs, ghosts, aliens, Bigfoot, conspiracy theories, and, of course, the paranormal, come to the dating site inspired by George Norrie. It's always free to search, and if you decide to upgrade to our amazing new features, use promo code George for a great discount. ParanormalDate.com. You are not alone.
Did you hear Nancy Pelosi could be worth as much as $250 million and Dr. Fauci just revealed he's worth more than $10 million? If you're tired of hypocrisy, watch Stinchfield each weekday at 8 p.m. Eastern on Newsmax. Brent Stinchfield exposes the Washington insiders in his series Hypocrites in America. Get Newsmax on every major cable system or free on your smart TV or streaming platforms. Millions are turning to Newsmax, a source you can trust. Watch Stinchfield tonight on Newsmax TV.
So, I just picked out the perfect ring, and that night my girlfriend started seeing ads for wedding dresses. I haven't even popped the question yet. Why is she seeing ads for things based on what I'm looking at online? I downloaded the DuckDuckGo app, and I stopped getting creepy ads right away. DuckDuckGo is the easy button for privacy. With one simple download, you can search, browse, and email privately. Take back your privacy online for free with DuckDuckGo. Privacy simplified.
First, we decide where we want to go. Then, we need to know the best way to get there. Hi, my name's Adam Barada. I'm the owner of Advantage Gold. We're the highest-rated precious metals firm in the country. We teach people how to own physical gold and silver. Now, we've won the Best of TrustLink Award 4 years in a row because we educate our clients on how to buy gold and silver the right way. We don't pay celebrity spokespeople millions of dollars. We'd rather pass that value on to you. Call 800-900-8000 and speak with one of our experts. We'll send you a free gold kit along with my latest number one national best-selling book, The Great Devaluation. Call 800-900-8000. That's 800-900-8000. Get the best information, the best process, the best service, the best value. Call Advantage Gold at 800-900-8000. Call 800-900-8000.
Coast to Coast, George Norrie with you. We're going to take calls with Bill Bean next hour. Definitely share some of your demonic possession stories. He is an exorcist as well. How often do you perform exorcisms, Bill?
Well, the traveling cut way down when the, with the COVID garbage. That's a whole other show as well. But I continue, George, to do these sessions and continue to do so, to have these Skype and phone sessions. I still travel with people, but not as much as I was. Still every single day, and it's become almost a 24/7 type of thing. I get very little sleep. I sleep when I can, but there are times, like right now, on the East Coast where I live, it's 3:40 a.m. I don't get to bed most mornings before 6 or 6:30 a.m. and a lot of that comes from having sessions with these people. I may be having a session with somebody in Australia or something that's 16 hours ahead of where I am in Maryland, and I could be, you know, having a session at this time or 4 or 5, 6, sometimes even 7 a.m. I had a recent session with a lady in New York City at 7:15 a.m. It's just, it's an amazing journey. I could not do this without the power of God working through me and restoring me after each and one, every one of these types of things. It's just, I don't know what to say other than it is very supernatural in every sense of the word. I take the suffering of others very personally based on my own sufferings. I do firmly believe that this is increasing due to the times that we are in and the times that are coming. And so I'm doing the best that I can do by the power of God working through me to help as many people as I possibly can. And then I have a little show that I do, which I treat more as a church service, where we feature praise and worship music, and we have guests on, but I make it a mission to spiritually feed people each and every Sunday, George, because I so strongly feel that now is the time for people to come back to God, whether they want to or not, or whether they realize what's going on in the world or not. It, in my opinion, it is now time for people to come back to God.
Well, good for you, Bill. Now, talking about coming back to things, you've had some UFO experiences in your life, haven't you?
Throughout most of my life, you know, the first sighting that I had was in 1977 at that house that we talked about a little while ago. And I was with my family. My dad left us in 1975, but he came back for a visit in 1977. And during that visit, we were in the living room watching TV. The power went out. He goes outside to see what happened. He thought maybe it was an accident and someone had struck a utility pole or something. He comes running back in, collects us. We go out in the backyard and we see this this object that was, I guess you could say, disc-shaped. But it had something on the bottom, too. So it kind of looked like a chef's hat. And it was very bright white. And no sound coming from it at all. It was hovering in the same place. You would see a gentle wobble coming from it from time to time. And other families were out in their yards as well watching it. And then it just gradually started to ascend, and it very slowly headed off to the north. And after that, the power came back on. So that was the first sighting. And then in January of 1995, I began to have frequent UFO sightings and interactions with non-human-looking beings, also surveillance from the Men in Black and perhaps government agencies. As crazy as that might sound, I assure you it's all true, and the black copters and everything else. And I find it interesting also, George, that over the years, no matter what city I've been in, whether it would be St. Louis or Tampa, Florida, Houston, Texas, those are three cities that I could think of. Even in the Virgin Islands, where I went to help a person in St. Thomas in the Virgin Islands, these copters were there. And when I would come out of the homes of affected individuals. Even, I'm thinking of the St. Louis one right now. It was about, like, I don't know, 3:30 in the morning or something, very, very late, coming out, and there's a copter right there, right over top of me. I can't explain it except to say that I praise God for keeping me safe, for keeping me alive. Are these copters an object? I've seen the black triangles many times as well. Are they sinister forces? I don't know. I can't say for sure because they haven't revealed themselves to me. They haven't landed. Although, you know, when I first started having these experiences, I did have encounters to where I saw these 7-foot-tall, non-human-looking beings, one at the foot of my bed one time and then another one that manifested in front of me in 2001. It looked, it was at least 7 feet tall. It was glowing like a yellow-green color. It had very long, skinny arms. The big black eyes, I saw it clearly for several seconds, and then it just vanished. And the worst part of that experience was that I had to walk through that very spot to get to my car. And let me tell you, that was one uncomfortable experience. But I have seen and experienced some things in my life that most people, A, probably wouldn't believe, even if they've seen it with their own eyes, or B, would just absolutely either die of a heart attack or just be in a mental institution or something. So I praise God for keeping me sane and for keeping me alive.
You've had some Bigfoot experiences, too.
I sure have. And a recent one as well. We live here, where we live, we're close to a wooded area. And I find it interesting that this wooded area goes along Severn River, which leads all the way up past where NSA is. And my opinion about that, I think that it's all connected, George. I truly do. The paranormal, supernatural, divine, demonic, and these the UFOs and then these non-human-looking beings, people want to call them aliens or whatever. Some people think they're demons, and they very well could be. And the Bigfoot creatures, I believe, are the offspring of the offspring. I think that when the sons of God came down to Bani Elohim, they came down, took human women, produced a hybrid offspring of giants called the Nephilim. The Nephilim had unnatural sex acts with the beast of the field, and that's why the Bigfoot creatures, some look like elks and bears and wolves and some look human. And I think that they are the offspring of the offspring, and they're every bit as much supernatural as they are a flesh and blood creature. Furthermore, there are many reports of Bigfoot being linked with UFOs, coming in and going out of UFOs, and orbs of light going through the forest, you know, associated with these creatures. So we're scratching the surface on truly understanding how all of this works. And then some people think that the UFOs are completely demonic. I disagree with that, and I'll tell you why. Because in the scripture, Psalm 68:17 says the chariots of God are 20,000. So I could show you many scriptures. Here's another one in Zechariah 6:1, and I turned and lifted up mine eyes and looked, and behold, there came 4 chariots out from between 2 mountains, and the mountains were mountains of brass. So there are many descriptions of UFOs in the Bible, and I feel that our God, who created everything, perhaps created them, and they were the flying Merkaba, the divine chariot of Yahweh in the heavenly host. And then when Hasatan, Satan the devil, was cast out of heaven with a third of the angels, perhaps they came down in crafts that were these imana crafts that are demonic in nature. And then when you look at other things, we know that our governments now have this type of technology. So that's another thing to factor in. And perhaps in the vastness of the universe that Yahweh created, who's to say that he didn't create other beings out there, that there are life out there on all these other planets? That is beyond my understanding, but I could accept that if the universe is that vast, why would he just create life here on this planet? And so if he did create life elsewhere out there, then certainly it's plausible that they could come here and have an interaction as well. Now, I will say this, This is another thing that I firmly believe, as we see everything unraveling, not just in America, but the world, is it possible that there is going to be a quote-unquote alien invasion that may take place soon? Is it going to be a real invasion? Is it going to be a fabricated invasion? God only knows this, but I do think that it is going to play a part as we continue through these end days. And so this is why it is so very important. For me, I wouldn't dare force anything on anybody, but what I can do is share my faith and how I go about my life. Am I perfect? No. Do I claim to be perfect? No. That would make me a liar. But I do the best that I can do, and I try to be the best that I can be each and every day of my life, because I make God first in my life, and as part of making God first, I have a responsibility and obligation to my fellow man also.
And you're very spiritual, aren't you?
God is everything. And again, look, I'm a flesh and blood man. I'm no better than you or anybody else.
But
I am sincere in my commitment to God, and I am sincere in my commitment to my fellow man to try and do the best that I can do to help anybody and everybody that comes in my path on a daily basis.
Since you've been doing this, have you met somebody that you just felt a little strange about? That they might be ETs?
Many times throughout the course of my lifetime, when I first started having those regular UFO experiences, I've had some of those men in black encounters. I've also had encounters with people that just suddenly came into my life, somebody that I, you know, didn't know. And this person just all of a sudden pops up, and then I find out that they've got ties with the government and military. And then I think to myself, okay, are these people being sent to monitor me? Or, you know, I have no idea, George. I just try to move forward in my life, and I give my life to God. And in turn, he keeps me safe and blessed and protected. So, yes, to answer your question, yeah, strange people have come into my life at various times during the course of my life, but God has helped me every single time. And also, I could think of a handful of times before I went to perform an exorcism on someone that God showed me a vision. In one case, it was the Caleb Weaver case, and that was featured on the A Haunting series as well. Caleb was fully possessed. And before I was going over to do the exorcism on him, God showed me a vision, very vivid, that Caleb was going to try and stab me.
Jeez.
And I took it seriously. And
During the exorcism?
Yes. And so the amazing thing about that is I had an assistant with me on that, and we bound his hands. After everything was over with, and he also spit the, when I put the, I use a holy mixture of holy water, holy oil, and holy salt, and frankincense as well, I put in as a mixture, and I applied that to his forehead and made the sign of the cross, and some of that dripped down, and he spit that back on me, and then he started this maniacal, demonic laugh, and so then he, as he was doing that, he buried his head. Sorry, I was trying to look him in the eye. And he buried his head, and I literally grabbed him by his hair and pulled him back up. And when my eyes went into his eyes, he had this anguished look on his face. And his head went all the way back, facing the ceiling. And this black garbage started coming out of him. And he was being delivered at that moment by the power of God again. I don't claim to be anything special. It's the power of God working through me. And so that was astonishing, just the deliverance aspect of it and him being freed like that. But after it was all over with, he told me, he said, I'm so sorry. I wanted to kill you. I just wanted to kill you. And he's not the only one, George. There have been other people, you know, like I mentioned earlier about these other weapons that and physical struggles. This is dangerous, and I don't recommend this. I've had people come to me and offer me money for me to train them in this, and I say to them, look, unless this is a true calling from God, I'm not going to do this because I don't want you to enter into something like this and then become like the seven sons of Sheba who were torn to pieces by those demons when they went in there to try and get them out. So this, in my opinion, and some would disagree with me because they'd say, well, the scripture says that you can bind and rebuke and cast out demons. Yes and no. When you're going at it full scale like this, unless it is a calling from God, I say no. Do not. If ever there was a disclaimer, don't try this at home, it would be for this type of thing.
I've got your website is BillJBean.com. Is that the same one?
That's it.
We've got it linked up for you at coasttocoastam.com. When we come back later, we're going to talk about Purge and take calls in our final hour with Bill Bean. Are you glad you do what you do?
I am. You know, here I've told you all these terrible things, but I have to say to you, it's the greatest thing in the world to know what your purpose in life is. And for so long, I was like a spinning top. I didn't know what my purpose in life was, and I was just trying to get through each and every day. And then when God put this calling on my life, first I resisted it because I felt unworthy. But then when I started to realize that this was a real and authentic calling that he's putting on my life, then I dedicated myself to studies. And it took me, I'd say, 3 years before I had the confidence to be able to go out there and truly trust God and know that he would work through me to help these people.
When you tell people you're an exorcist, what do they say?
Well, some people go, whoa, what? You know, and even in, it's so sad, even in a lot of churches of today, they don't teach about spiritual warfare. They would rather just have a cookie cutter message and not even talk about anything evil. And that is a disservice to people because some of those very people sitting in those churches are suffering spiritually and they are medicated because they're trying to escape the pain and the torment and the suffering that is going on in their life. And then some of those people go to their pastor or their priest and they tell them, and then they're rejected, they're turned away. And a lot of those people come to me because they've been rejected by their churches.
Bill, when we come back, we're going to talk about your latest book, Purge, and then we'll take phone calls on Coast to Coast Day.
Find out more about tonight's guest. Log on to coasttocoastam.com.